Welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Heroes, Song of the Ocean, Blind. Why are we leaving? Trying to avoid monsters. Back at the tunnel, or the cave path, I think it's called. I missed some stuff, and you guys are probably yelling at me. I think I missed an item in Dogarna as well, but I'm not going all the way back there. Pardon me. It's like three screens away, so figure I'd leave it in if you guys want to miss something also and you want to see how to get back there. I'm not sure if it's down this way. It's not. Okay. There's a chest over here, right? Yeah, I got that. Alright. I swear I stepped up to one of those, like, there's some walled-off places. Like, doors that are, like, barred or sealed. You can bust them open. And I swear I went up to one of them and clicked there and it didn't work. So, because it didn't work, I figured it's nothing, it's just scenery. Yeah, I went through here. So, we gotta get this stuff. I try to be as complete as I can. But this is a blind playthrough, not a walkthrough, so stuff is gonna be missed sometimes. To my eternal chagrin. Here. Use Rock Crash? Yes. That's why I missed that and at least one other door. We got a wolf's claw. So, I mean, I should have known because when you go up to it, you can see there's a tunnel. Shrug. Alright, so it's McBain who has the gloves. Okay, so this is an improvement for him. Attack goes up by 6. And it's free! Yay! So that's that bridge. That's nothing. I think this is where we come into the cave. Just verify that. Yep. And over here somewhere is where we fought those monsters. Oh no, it must have been up more then. I'm gonna be right on it. Maybe I wasn't right on it. Ah, the spare key that we found in Dogarna. So if we had come here before, we wouldn't have been able to open this, I guess. What if I say no? Obviously. I just wanted to see if it would say anything. Economy ring. What's an economy ring? Oh, it makes things cost less when you buy them? That's helpful. I don't know why I'm going there. I'm guessing this is an accessory, yeah. Ring with fragrant olive smell. Wear it and you'll feel calm. Saves magic points. Can Jan wear it? What does this do? Jolly key. What's a jolly key ring? I forget. I have to unequip it just to see what it does. So it'll show up in items again. Oh, wool key ring that cheers you up and increases critical rate. Ding, 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 ding. I love that. Might as well give it to Forte, I guess. And then they can get this economy ring. So you should be able to heal more. That's what I'm thinking. We don't use the stones that much. I mean, not yet anyway. Any more doors to bash open? I think over here is where we found the monsters. Right. Right, I've been over here, yeah. There was just two? And I came all the way back here. I just want to make sure I get them all. You know how it is. Nope, that leads to that area. Yeah, that's it. We came all the way back for an economy ring and wolf's gloves. So do we still have the spare key? Oh, it's been used up. It's been used up. Okay, it was just for that. I thought it was going to be useful against, you know, well, against, but useful for multiple chests and stuff. I think this is where we want to go. Somewhere around here. So back to whatever this city is called, I forget, this town. From what I understand, it's quite large, so I'm gonna have a fun time looking around and stuff. I always like looking around towns and talking to everybody, exploring. Dead ends in the wilderness, not so much. Unless there's a chest at the end, which we have not opened. Pardonnez-moi, monsieur. Okay. Envorin, right. Well, here we got. Oh, it's not potions, or rather, liquor, and I don't know why we have this. I always wonder that. I guess it's the guest list? You're registering a room? Why they have that insignia for inns? I'm on the wrong side of the counter. The sailors took away the liquor barrels by force, saying that they were for the party in Rio Tom Island. All we have left is wine. Without liquor, our regulars have stopped coming. The soldiers didn't even pay. They told me to send the bills to the Duke. I don't think the castle will accept our bills. Oh man, we'll be out of business. Wow. Those sailors need to pay. Grandpa Raparo says, Envorin has become a much bigger place compared to what it was before. But then, we have an uncanny merchant like Rish controlling the city now. I like the old Envorin better. The Duke must grow up. I wish Viscount Eagle was by his side. The Duke must grow up. Canuck? I spelled that wrong. I'm so obsessed. The sailors from Muth took away all the liquor from the tavern. They only have wine left. Yeah, so we've heard. Wine doesn't work for me. Well, you're whining about it. They took all of the flour last time, and we couldn't have bread for some time. Now it's liquor this time? Give me a break already. We do not need rest, so just check. If you're looking for a room, please come to the counter. Yeah, I love that. That's one of my favorite things to check out. Why they don't like when you go behind the counter. They don't all react in this game, but in the other two games they did. I mean, I don't think there'd be any secrets because they're right at the bottom of the screen, but it still looks inviting, doesn't it? Looks like there could be a hidden way. Yes. Okay. Oh. It looks like steps. I thought we could climb up there. Muth, East, 43 Milos. McBain says, oops, this road will lead to Muth. We haven't seen the Duke yet. We must keep our promise with Viscount Eagle. That's right, says Forte. We still have the letter from the Viscount. It keeps bothering me. We must see the Duke first, says McBain. Why is it bothering you? See, and I thought we saw... Yeah, you can just barely see it. Up here. Oh. You can see the water. See it? So the road doesn't actually go anywhere. I guess we're gonna have to get a boat over there. I wonder if we're gonna end up down in that aqueduct system. Greetings. Flan says, my sister always spends so much time packing. It's just a trip. She should learn to pack quickly. I hear you've been told to pick up the pace. She moves quickly. Mattia says, I'm going to see my friend in Polka. I haven't finished packing yet. Well, make sure you bring your accordion. I must quickly pack up and go to the port of Muth. They say the place is filled with ferry passengers. Ferry, not fairy passengers. Oh, I must hurry. Every time I pack, I always find these useless things. Fred, book 5? Here, it's yours. Awesome. Forte and his friends was forced to take Fred, book 5. Forte says, what? Why? I must quickly pack up and go to the port of Muth. Oh, I must hurry. Mm. Alright, our next Fred book. Upset that there's no Barney book. Barney Rubble has not been represented adequately. Runka says, the bakery has been closed for so long, I'm having trouble remembering their menu. I can only recall the main dishes. I hope they will open again soon. Shinka says, we saw a fat man and a lady. They were performers. Oh, is it those two? The one with the green hair? Do you know them? Forte says, a fat man and a lady who are performers? I forget their name. What's the girl's name? Rachel or something? No, Rachel's the one who was in love with Mile from... Isn't that her? I'm getting all the names mixed up. I was thinking Rachel was the one who fell in love with Mile from A Tear of Vermilion. Anyway, Forte says, a fat man and a lady who are performers? I have a bad feeling, says McBean. Shinka says, does the fat man play? Where will he play? I want to see him. Oh, you want to see him. Okay, good for you. Oh, there's a bread place. Whoops. Oh, we've changed into Altos. Uncle Edgar. Hello. Altos, it's been a long time. Thank you for coming. How are you feeling? Says Altos. My father told me that you had to close your store. Of course, I see now that it's open again. I didn't close the store because I was sick. I couldn't run it for another reason. By the way, who are your friends? This is the McBain Company. They're troubadours. We happen to be heading in the same direction, so I accompany them. I see. My name is Edgar. I've been a friend of Altos's father since our apprenticeship days. I'm McBain. Nice to meet you. Altos says, we have to run some errands at the Envorin Castle. We'll come back later. Oh, he's staying with us? I thought we were dropping him off now. At the castle? What is it? Says Edgar. Una says, Viscount Ugul of Dagarna entrusted us with his personal letter. Oh, Viscount Ugul. How kind of you to have come all this way for him. Is he well? He was doing well, then he fought with a monster and got wounded. He's fine now, thankfully. Haha, he probably thinks he's still young. He's always so full of spirit. Do you know Viscount Ugul? Asks Altos. He used to live in Envorin when he was young. He was like a good brother to us. McBain says, let's go to the castle, shall we? I can't relax until we finish these errands. I thought you were going to the castle, says Edgar. Yeah, in good time. Oh, I can't. That's a wall. Okay. We have ye old weapon shoppy here. Can we go behind the counter and bother him? Yes. Well, he'll just take our order anyway. Soldier sword for Forte. Finely decorated long sword. Produces sharp cuts, also used in duels, etc. It's expensive. So I don't want to give it to Altos. He's going to leave us soon. I know, I'm being frugal. Okay, for Una, the hunter bow. Bow for professional hunters. Not so powerful, but ease of use is first class. Okay, so we already got the wolf's glove for McBain. I didn't look at it. A sharp knife is embedded in impact area, a deadly weapon in experienced hands. I didn't read the description for it. A pirate shield for Forte. It's cheap. I'll get the shield for Altos as well. Shield with sharp spikes at the center, placed on broadsides of a pirate ship. Okay, rivet armor. Armor with rivets on its shoulders and back. Favored by adventurers and bandits. Our avoidance goes down without. Well, I'm getting at least... I'm getting two. Let's see what it does for Una. Because I see her avoidance goes down. First, we'll give the soldier sword. Wow, that's hard. To Forte. I'm gonna get rid of the cure sword after all now. So yeah, he just went up by 6 points. Pirate shield defense up by 2. Rivet armor. His defense is up another 4. Oh, earth armor? Oh. It's not as good. So, oh, she's got the Mirage Mail. the way her avoidance goes down so much with it, I'm gonna keep her with the Mirage Mail. Wait. That wasn't keeping it with the Mirage Mail. Okay. Okay, so McBain's just gonna get this rivet armor. Defense up by 4. And I'll get him. Oh wow, we've had a shield for him. Oh, this might have been actually. The hell, Forte. This circle shield might have been Forte's. Okay, so in any case, he wasn't even using any kind of shield, so his defense has just gone up by 8 points. Alright, let's sell some of this stuff back. Sailor Sword. I'll save one just in case someone comes with no armor or something. Okay. Got almost as much money as we started out with. Oh, they have a little fountain too, okay. Really similar to some of the other towns we've seen. Until it looks like we can walk up those boxes like a ladder. Hello? Rana says, Rana's daddy is not coming back. He went to protect the party on Ryotam Island. Always talk about yourself in the third person? I miss him. Hick, hick. What's with the hiccuping? Dad, come back soon. Serena says, not only soldiers, but many workers were also ordered to help with the preparations for the party under the name of National Service. My husband has also gone to Ryotam Island as a guard at the order of the Duke. My daughter misses her father so much. I should give my daughter her favorite mint candy to cheer her up. We have mint candy. It's just a merchant's party. Why must the entire country help? We are struggling to earn our living. I'm giving them mint candy. An option to do that. Grandma Daria says, Rish, I hate that merchant. Ever since he began business dealings in the Principality of Pensola, this country has changed. He is such a plague. Wow. Grand buildings have been built, but prices have gone up and we don't have much goods. I can't help but think that the Duke of Pensola has sold his soul to that devil, Rish. The devil, I tell ya. Rig says, I saw them. Scores of soldiers came from Dogarna and headed toward Muth. They were probably on their way to Ryotam Island. Ryotam Island must be such a boring place now, being filled with all those soldiers. They might be fun soldiers, you never know. It looks like he's waiting for us. Beckett says, they say a terrible monster showed up in Dogarna to the south. But the soldiers who were supposed to guard the region have all been sent to Ryotam Island. What is the Duke of Pensola thinking? He was always a bit selfish, but ever since the Viscount left, he's become increasingly cruel. Hmm. That's not good. Thanks. Ah. What else is around here? The bread place again, I guess. Did we go in here? I think so. Oh yeah, she's the one packing. Did I talk to them? Oh yeah. This is the Embassy of Marcheros. We issue visas to Marcheros for those entering the country. Oh, there's a chest back there. Later, dude. Orb of Ocean 74. There's nothing different in particular. What if there was something different, not in particular? 74, I said? A marble with the image of the Duke of Pensola can be viewed in the Ocean album. Forget where that is. I forget. Ocean album. I know it's in a different area. Oh, here. Yeah, I doubt I'm gonna get all these. sincerely doubt. Rachel! Her name was Rachel! Oh, wasn't it Stephanie? I think her name was Stephanie, yeah, who... the one who was in love with Mile in A Tear of a Million. Stephanie. So it was Rachel and Shao that they were that other NPC was talking about. Pensola Normal. That's the Duke of Pensola, huh? Okay, so we meet him there first. Rupthia. Okay. Hello there. Welcome to the Embassy of Marcheros. May I help you? McBean says, we're here to get a visa to Marcheros. You're applying for a visa. McBean handed over the passport. The McBean Company, right? Two males and one female. And a dog? Well, the desert rat is a mascot, so it doesn't need a visa. The secretary affixed a visa stamp on the passport. Hey, what about our cat? Here you go. Forte and his friends receive a passport. As Rish's party draws near, I feel that the entire country of Pensola is losing its calm. It's not my home country, but I'm worried. You better worry. Oops. That's it? That's the whole place? I don't think we've been in that. Whatever's up here to the north. It's the embassy, isn't it? I'm sure it is. Okay. We will enter it next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always... seek adventure.